Okay, students, we have studied about differential operators and what are the different, how to simplify, how to find the factors, how to find, do the integrated multiplication and all. So, we will study some of the properties of these differential operators. So, first property of this differential operator is nothing but, if, imagine if I will assume f of d is a differential operator, differential polynomial of degree n, then f of d into e power mx is nothing but e power mx into f of m. So, first property of differential operator of degree n is nothing but f of d into e power mx is equal to e power mx into f of m. Suppose this m is the root of this polynomial f of d of degree n, what will happen? You know that if it is a root, I will get f of m is equal to 0. Yes or no? So, f of m is equal to 0, then what this equation will happen? This equation will happen f of d into e power mx is equal to 0. So, this is equal to 0. So, you know the what is the linear homogeneous differential equation of order n. What is that? F of d into y is equal to 0. So, this is the linear homogeneous differential equation of order n. So, when I compare these both equation, I can write y is equal to e power mx. So, e power y is equal to e power mx is the solution of f of d into y is equal to 0, where f of d is a polynomial of degree n. This is the solution when f of m is equal to 0, that is m is a root of f of d. Okay, we'll solve one problem so that you can understand better. Okay, solve 2d square plus 5d minus 12 into y is equal to 0. So, we have to solve this equation. I will consider this equation as f of d is equal to 2d square plus 5d minus 12. Now, what we have to do is, first we have to find the auxiliary equation. So, f of m is equal to 2m square plus 5m minus 12. So, this is nothing but the auxiliary equation. Then we have to find the roots of this auxiliary equation. So, to find the roots of auxiliary equation, we substitute f of m is equal to 0. So, this implies 2m square minus plus 5m minus 12 is equal to 0. So, this is now a quadratic equation and you have to solve this and find its roots. So, you on multiplication I should get minus 24 and on subtraction I should get plus 5. So, that is nothing but 2m square plus 8m minus 3m minus 12 is equal to 0. So, this is one set, this is one set, I will group this. So, I will get 2m into m plus 4 minus 3 into m plus 4 is equal to 0. So, I will get m plus 4 into 2m minus 3 is equal to 0. So, on simplification, clearly I will get the value as m is equal to minus 4 and 2m is equal to 3, that is nothing but m is equal to 3 by 2. So, we got two roots here. Since it is a quadratic equation, we will get two roots. So, one is m is equal to minus 4, another one is m is equal to 3 by 2. So, how we will write the solution of it? That is nothing but y is equal to, you have said the property that if m is a root of that equation, then the solution can be written as y is equal to mx is the solution of that. So, here there are two roots, one is minus 4, another one is 3 by 2. So, the solution is nothing but y is equal to e to the power minus 4x and one more is y is equal to e to the power plus 3 by 2 x. So these are the two solutions of that, of the given equation d 2d square plus f 5d minus 12 into y is equal to 0. So now we will see, we have seen the first property of this differential operator. We will see the second property of the differential operator. Okay. So what the second property says? Second property says that if f of d is the differential equation of degree n, then e power ax into f of d into y is nothing but f of d minus a into e power ax into y. So if you are having the equation of the form e power ax into f of d into y, then f of d minus a into e power ax into y. So here also we will solve one problem so that you can understand better. Solve d plus 3 whole power y is equal to 0. So you have to solve this equation. What we will do is, first we will multiply both the sides by e power 3x. So what we will get that term? D plus 3 whole power 4 into e power 3x into y is equal to 0. Now you have observed here e power ax into f of d into y, if that form is there, then you can write f of d minus a into e power ax into y. So what we will do is, here I can write this as d plus 3 minus 3 whole power 4 into e power 3x into y is equal to 0. So here what will happen? 3 and 3 get cancelled. So I will remain with d power 4 into e power 3x into y is equal to 0. Now we have to find the solution of this equation. So we will discuss how to find the solution of this equation d power 4 into e power 3x into y is equal to 0 in our next class. Thank you.